Hello coders, in this video we are going to discuss one of the most commonly used plot in data science, a bar plot. Bar plot shows the relationship between a numerical and a categorical variable. It presents categorical data with rectangular bars with heights proportional to the values that they represent. The bars can be plotted vertically or horizontally. We will use this bar plot in machine learning to compare different algorithms based on their accuracy, precision, recall, etc. To discuss bar plot, here I have mentioned some samples. In recent test, these many students got these grades A, B, C, and D. We want to compare their performance after each test. Also, we want to know in which test out of three students got the highest number of A grades. So in the future, we can take some improvement measures. So let's get started. As you can see over here, for received samples, here I have created four Python list. Grades. Test 1, test 2, and test 3. Let me execute this cell. To explain you a bar plot, here I have mentioned some questions that you can see over here. So let's solve them one by one. I request you to watch up to the end. I am sure you will learn something. So let's get started. So let me import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Let me import numpy as np because we require numpy in one of the question. So let me execute this cell. So now in question number one, we have to draw a bar plot. So for that, we have to write plt.bar method of this matplotlib. So let me pass grades on x-axis and test one on y-axis. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying a nice bar plot that you can see over here. Grades and number of students. As you can see over here, in test 1, 3 students got A grade. Around, you can see over here, around 13 students got B grade. Around 10 students got C grade. Around 5 students got D grade. That you can see over here. To remove this line in Jupyter notebook, we have to write plt.show. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, it is not necessary to write plt.show if you are using this Jupyter notebook, but you have to write this plt.show if you are using any other editor. So as you can see over here, this way we can draw a bar plot using this bar method of this matplotlib. So now next question. So in this question, we have to give title, x label and y label to this created bar plot. So let me copy this code and let me paste it over here. So let's first give title. So plt dot title. Let me write bar plot. PLT dot X label. Let me write grades. PLT dot Y label. Let me write number of students. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, this way we can give title to our graph, X label and Y label. That you can see over here. So now next question. So in this question we have to change font size of title, x label and y label. So let me copy this code to save our recording time and let me paste it over here. Let's first change font size of title. Let me give 15. As you can see over here, to change font size of the title, here we have to use font size parameter of this title method. Same we can change font size of x label. Let me give 10. Same for y label. Let me give 10. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, bar plot, grades and number of students. As per your requirement, you can change font size using this font size parameter of title, x label and y label. That you can see over here. So now next question. So in this question we have to set width of the bars and also we have to align bars to center. So let me copy this code and let me paste it over here. So if you want to get more information about this bar method, then you can press shift tab over here to check the doc string of this bar method. As you can see over here, now we are going to change this width parameter, the width of the bar. By default value is 0.8, that you can see over here. Now let's change width to 0.3. Let me execute this cell. as you can see over here. Now width is set to 0.3, that you can see over here. Also we have to align the bars to center. So for that, let me write align. So let me check docstring of this bar method. Let me click over here. As you can see over here, by default value of this align parameter is center. As you can see over here, we can give either center or edge. By default value is center. So now let me give edge. Let me execute this cell. Please look at here. Let me give center. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here. So this way we can align bars. So this way we can set width of the bars and align bars to center using this width parameter and using this align parameter of this bar method. So now next question. So in this question we have to change color of the bars and also we have to change edges color of the bars. So now let me copy this code and let me paste it over here. So here let me press shift tab to check docstring of this bar method of matplotlib. As you can see over here, color parameter. So color or list of color, which is optional. So the colors of the bar faces. Also we can change edge color. Color or list of color. Again it is optional. The colors of the bar edges. So we are going to use this color parameter and also we are going to use this edge color parameter to set the colors of the bar edges and color parameter to the colors of the bar faces. So let me close this docstring and let me first write color. So here we can write any color name, yellow. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, also we can pass list over here. So you can write any four color names. So let me write yellow, K for black, G for green and B for blue. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, different colors for each bar, that you can see over here. So this way we can change color of each bar using this Python list. So if you want to keep same color for all the bars, then here you have to write only one color name. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here. So this way we can use color parameter of this bar method. So here you can pass color name as a string or Python list as per your requirement. Now let's change color of the edges. So for that we have to use edge color parameter of this bar method. Let me change it to black. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, color of the edges has been changed to black, as you can see over here. This way you can use color parameter to change face color of the bar. And this way we can use edge color parameter of this bar method to change edge color of the bars, that you can see over here. So now next question. So in this question we have to change line styles and also we have to change line width of the bars. To save recording time, let me copy this code and let me paste it over here. So let me press shift tab over here to check docstring of this bar method. As you can see over here, line style or ls, and these are the possible values that you can pass to this line style parameter. So in place of line style also we can write ls. To change line width we can use this line width parameter, or we can write lw for line width. In that we can pass any floating point value. So let me copy this docstring, let me close this, let me create cell above and let me paste it over here. Let me use line style parameter. Let me change it to dotted line style. So for that we have to use this colon. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here. So this way we can change line style of the bars. So now let's change line width. So for that we can use line width parameter or LW. Let me set it to 4. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here. So let me change it to 2. Let me execute this cell. So now it's looking better. So this way we can change line style and line width of the bars. In place of this line style we can write ls as well. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here. So now next question. So in this question we have to draw bar plots for test 1 and test 2. Main purpose of this question to show you how we can plot bar plots side by side. So let me copy this code to save our recording time and let me paste it over here. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, bar plot for test 1. But as per our question, we have to draw bar plots for test 1 and test 2 side by side. So let me copy this code over here. Let me change it to test 2. Let me change color of this bar plot to blue. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, bar plots are overlapping for test 1 and test 2. We want to display this bar side by side for test 1 and test 2. So let's create numpy array with name index. So np.arrange with length of grades. So we are going to create numpy array with length of x-axis value, which is grade in our case, because we are going to pass this created numpy array on x-axis to plot bars side by side. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, these grades contain four values A, B, C, and D. So here numpy is created with four values 0, 1, 2, and 3. So now let's pass this index in place of grades, because we want these bars side by side. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, still it is overlapping. Now we want test 2 bars over here, 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 and here. So here we have to add one scalar value. I am going to add 0.3. So that's why here we have created numpy in place of Python list, because numpy performs operations element wise. So this scalar value will be added element wise. So 0.3 plus 0, 0.3 plus 1, 0.3 plus 2, 0.3 plus 3. So I am taking 0.3 because we have set width of the bars to 0.3. You can try for any other scalar values as per your requirement. So now let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying bars side by side for test 1, test 2, test 1, test 2, test 1, test 2, test 1, and test 2. So let me change this scalar value to 5. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying our bar plot like this. So here it is better to use 0.3. So as per your requirement, you can select different scalar value over here, as you can see over here. So this way we can draw bar plots for test 1 and test 2 that you can see over here. But here the problem is, now it is showing floating point values over here in place of grades A, B, C, and D. So for that, we have to use plt.xtix method of this matplotlib and index comma grades. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is displaying grades A, B, C, and D. Also, we can move these grades towards left side or right side as per our requirement. So let me add scalar value over here, 0.3. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, let me change it to 0.2. Let me execute this cell. Now it's look better, that you can see over here. So as per your requirement, here also you can add some scalar value. So this way we can draw bar plots for test 1 and test 2. So now next question. So in this question, we have to draw plots for test 1, test 2, and test 3. So let me copy this code and let me paste it over here. Just we have to add test 3. Let me copy and paste it over here. Let me change it to 3. And here we have to use 0.6. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, let me change color of this test 3 bars to green. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, grades A, B, C, and D. So let me change this scalar value 2.3. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is properly showing A, B, C, and D at the middle of these bars. So this way, as per your requirement, you can change this scalar value. So this way we can draw bar plots for test 1, test 2, and test 3 that you can see over here. So now next question. So in this question, we have to add legend to our created bar plot. So for that, let me copy this code and let me paste it over here. And here we have to use plt.legend method of matplotlib. And we want to show this label inside this legend. Test 1, test 2, test 3. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, test 1, test 2 and test 3. Here you can see our legend. So this way we can add legend to our bar plot that you can see over here. Sometimes what will happen, your x-axis label may be larger in size. So also we can rotate these x-axis labels. So for that we have to use rotation parameter of this x-axis. And as per your requirement, you can rotate to particular degree. Let me rotate it to 60 degree. Let me execute this cell, as you can see over here. So if your labels are larger in size, then you can rotate as per your requirement that you can see over here using this rotation parameter of this x-axis method of matplotlib. So now next question. So in this question, we have to change figure size and figure color as well. So let me copy this code and let me paste it over here. So let me write plt dot figure method and fix size parameter of this figure method. In tuple we have to pass width and height in inches. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, figure size is changed. So now as per our question, also we have to change figure color. So for that we have to use face color parameter of this figure method. Let me change it to light green. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, figure color has been changed to light green. So now let's change edge color using edge color parameter of this figure method. So let me change it to black. Let me execute this cell. It is not showing this edge color because by default line width is set to 0. So let's change line width to 2. As per your requirement, you can pass any value to this line width parameter. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, now it is showing this face color and also edge color to our bar plot. So this way we can change figure size and figure color of our bar plot that you can see over here. So now next question. In this question, we have to change plot style and also we have to save the graph. So for that, let me copy this code and let me paste it over here. Let me execute this cell. So now to save our graph, here we have to write plt dot save fig. You can give any name. Let me write bar plot dot png. Let me execute this cell. So now this plot has been saved to our default location with name bar plot dot png. Also you can save by right clicking on this figure and press save image. And you can also save your graph. So this way we can save our graph. Now as per our question, also we have to change plot style. So let me create cell below. So now let's first check available styles in matplotlib. So for that we have to write plt dot style dot available. Let me execute this cell. So as you can see over here, these many styles are available. As per your requirement, you can use any style out of this. So now let's use one style using plt.style.use. Let's use seaborn style. So let me copy this and let me paste it over here. Let me execute this cell. So now let me copy this code and let me paste it over here. Let me execute this cell. As you can see over here, plot style has been changed that you can see over here to seaborn style that you can see over here. So as per your requirement, you can select style from here that you can see over here. So this way we can change plot style and we can save our graph that you can see over here. So this is all about bar plot. Please don't forget to subscribe this channel. If you like this video, smash that like button. Thank you very much for watching this video. Take care. Bye bye. See you in the next video.